today I have a first impressions video on some winter makeup that I've never tried before. I might have peeked in the boxes a little bit, but I did not try them before this video, so I'm really excited. I wanted to include kind of products that either look a little Christmassy or holiday-ish, or products that I would be using in the winter time. Some of these products were sent to me. I did purchase a few on my own. A lot of these products I've seen before, I just never tried, so I'm really excited to have them in my hand, seeing how they work. Obviously, I'm talking future tense because I've already tried it. This is the look on my face, which, oh my gosh, if you guys wanna see what were hits, what were misses, keep watching because it's really exciting. Bronzer didn't go so well today. I was kind of in a hurry, so don't mind the bronzer, but let's get started on the first product. What should we do first? I guess we should do the Lancome Ombre Hypno Stylo. Doing my best go there with that pronunciation. These are eyeshadow sticks that are really long lasting. I'm really excited to see how well these work. I have in three colors, 28, 30, and 31. Rubies, that's the red one. Amethyst is the purple one, and then blue chrome is the blue one. I'm gonna show you guys the colors. I love long-lasting eyeshadow sticks. They're like one of my favorite things ever, especially for winter because I like to wear a lot of dark colors, and if I have a eyeshadow that comes off really easily, it kind of makes the dark color look really, really bad. I'm gonna see the colors right here, and then I'm gonna take the lids off. So that's them. This one's more like a maroon. I think I called it a red. It's more like a maroon than the purple and the blue. All right, so how should we do this? Like a gradient kind of thing? I'm gonna do a quick swatch of this blue color. Really, really nice deep blue. I love how they all have like a shimmer to them. Then this is the purple. Oh, pretty. And then this is the red. Why do I keep calling it red? It's more like a pinkish maroon kind of, like that. These colors remind me of like a sunset, so I think I want to do kind of a sunset eye. I'm gonna start with blue. I'm gonna just use my fingers. I feel like that might be the easiest way to do it. I guess you could like take a brush and kind of brush it on. I'm gonna put this in the inner corner. It's so smooth going on, it's not pulling my skin at all. And I'll just like blend it a little. I feel like I should go a little bit past my thing because I have like the smallest eyelids ever, and it's kind of hard to see really cool colors that I do. Oh, and I forgot, since these are long lasting, I should probably blend them immediately or else they're just gonna like stick where I put them. Crazy pigmentation, like really, really nice. I'm gonna use the purple one now, the middle. Oh my god, they're so pretty. This is gonna be such an awesome eye for going to the grocery store because again, nothing to do today. But we're going full glam with it. So I'm gonna just do preliminaries. When working with stuff like these, like really long lasting eye pencils, it's definitely important to blend it out right when you put it on, but also build, because you're rarely gonna get what you want the first time you draw them on, just because of how quickly they set. All right, so I'm just gonna go in here, and this one, just wait for it, guys. This is gonna look cute, just wait. I know, it kinda looks a little weird right now. That's how it always is. I love watching Instagram videos like that. Do you like watching those too, where it just looks like a complete mess, and then it turns out looking gorgeous? Good. So you definitely can use a brush to blend this out. You just have to do it right after you place it, and then you can like use it to blend. I would use a dense brush. Like this brush is super dense and it's working amazing. I want to blend these two a little bit better. How's that looking so far? I'm gonna do this eye really quick and I'll be right back. So that is that. That is amazing. They blended together so nicely. And I'm just gonna take this under my eye too. So that's what we're gonna do right now. Oh my gosh, so now how I did swatches on my arm or my hand. This one I immediately wiped away when I drew it, then I just kind of did this to it. And you can see how it blended out a little bit. I didn't try to like make it even or anything, but you can see how it blended when I pulled my finger over it. But now look at these, now that they've dried, they aren't going anywhere. A little bit of water here that I'm gonna put on my finger because it does say it's waterproof. and put it on my hand. Oh my gosh, it's crazy. So, not coming off with water. Absolutely in love with these. I'm totally gonna use them a ton more. Oh my god. All right, so the next thing I'm gonna try is, let's do a face thing. I'm kind of feeling face really quick. This is the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Makeup Stick Blush. As you guys know, I love the contour sticks that come like this. I have the dark and a light one, but I have not tried their blush one, so I'm really excited to see how that's gonna look. I'm gonna grab this Real Techniques brush, and I'm gonna use that to blend it in. So I'm just gonna, I guess you just dot it on, right? Like, I'm just gonna draw. Ooh, can you see that color? It's really, like, faint, but it's a, I'll swatch it really quick. One color. So it's like kind of an orange shimmer, which I'm not a huge, but I guess I do kind of like shimmer blushes. They're just not my favorite. I'm gonna use this thing to blend in. I like using this better than my hands because I feel like I don't have the oil from my hands to move my makeup, even though it is set. I am wearing foundation. See a little bit of it? I'm gonna add a little more just so you guys can really see it. The Milani foundation that I use, it is shimmery, so I shouldn't say I don't like shimmery. I'm just not a huge fan of super shimmery. This is almost kind of a highlighter. The formula is nice. The only thing I will say, and this goes for the same thing for highlighters as well, that if you have, like, it really makes your texture of your skin show up. I get compliments all the time about my skin, and I am really happy with it. I really do like my skin. It is clear. I don't really get acne, and I don't have too much discoloration, so I do like it, but this definitely is bringing out the texture in it. So if you have anything on your face that you don't like, you know, to see, this is gonna bring it out a little bit just because of the shimmery of it. But it is easy to blend in. I might want to try a different shade color from this line. The next thing I'm gonna try is, we might as well do the eyeliner because my eyes need it badly. Teen tiny little guy. This is the Maneater Tarte eyeliner. I got this guy in a gift set that you guys saw in my Black Friday haul, and I have not tried it yet. It is a really nice, it's not dry at all. It's pretty liquidy. Not like too liquidy, but just, I hate the pen liners that don't feel like anything's coming out and it makes it hard to drag across your eye. I hate that. This is like my new favorite eyeliner. I'm sad I only have a teeny tiny little sample size. I wish I had like a larger size, and maybe I'll go back for it because it really is nice. So I did my other liner, and I also did my waterline and a little bit of blue right under this lash line, the bottom lash line. It was just speaking to me and I was like, I'm gonna add this, and I'm loving it. I think it's looking so good. So I'm gonna be trying the Lancome Definicils mascara. I was so shocked by this bottle. It, like, I didn't know this was a mascara. This looks like an eyeliner tube. I was like, what? And when I open it up, it's like, it looks like this. So this looks like it's gonna be awesome for my lower lashes, so I'm really excited to try it. High definition lengthening and separating mascara. That's exactly what I want for my bottom lashes. So we're gonna try that because I'm always looking for a bottom lash mascara, and I need bottom lash help. All right, let me show you up close what they look like. Definitely longer than usual, like a ton longer than usual. I know you're probably like, that's not that long. My lashes, like I said, are so freaking short. And they never go straight. With a lot of other mascaras, for some reason, they go in like different directions. I don't think I have that problem. But if you do, then we can both rejoice in this not doing that to me. This made them all really straight, which I like a lot. Now on the top lashes, I have a awesome looking mascara. Just because the bottle, I know it's awesome looking. This is from number 7, Lash Impact Ultra Instant False Lash Volume, which I'm really excited about. This you can get at like Walgreens, I think they said, kind of like drugstores, so it's definitely affordable, which is nice. This just reminded me of holiday, you know, the colors. Oh, so pretty. So I'm going to try this. Oh, I like the brush. It's kind of a thicker brush, a little bit bigger, you can see. Instant Impact with Big Bold Lashes from the first sweep and full bodied volume in just one coat. Ooh. I already pre-curled my top lashes. I know it doesn't look like it. Again, I do not have very great lashes. I always wear falsies because of that. I'm excited. I'm really impressed with the fact it's not like clumping up. Usually ones that say they're gonna give you like a lot of volume and a lot of body instantly clump up on your eyeballs, and it's like, what the heck? So, liking this. Again, my eyelashes are stick straight, so try not to judge it based on that. I'm building it up and it's still not clumping. I love that. Okay, so far so good. I'm going to like super curl this one to see if I can get like, you know, a little bit more curl because my eyelashes love to just straight. It really does not take many swipes to make your lashes look full either. Like what I usually do is I put mascara on my lashes before I put falsies on because I want them to blend. I'll do false lashes after this product because I'm really excited about this. I wanted to try it so bad. All of these products, no, I've never tried them before. But I do when I get them in the mail, I open them and just look at them. I don't use them. I don't even swatch them because I want to save that for my first impressions. But I do look at them because I can't help it. But this one, this is from Gerard Cosmetics. This is Longwear Hydra Matte Liquid Lipstick in Skinny Dip. I wanted to look at it so, so bad. But the way the lid is, if I pull it, it's going to rip it. And I was like, I can't do that because it'll like ruin the box for you guys. And I wanted to make it all pretty for the first impression. So I'm so excited. Ooh, the packaging looks gorgeous. It has gold, says Gerard Cosmetics. And then it's this pink color. See how the bottle is like a frost kind of material. I love it. We can swatch it really quick if you want. Like you can answer me. I'm just going to swatch it anyway. So pretty. Yeah, it's going on so easily. Take this stuff off. So what I really like about this, I'm touching it just now after I finish like my putting my false lashes and a little bit of extra highlighter on, but I'm just feeling my lips right now and I really like how it feels. It's unlike any other liquid lipstick I've tried because when I'm feeling my lips, like you can tell it's completely dry, like it's not gonna go anywhere, but it's almost like moisturizing my lips because I can feel a little bit of that. You know how most liquid lipsticks when you wear them you can like run your finger over and it feels dry and also dries out your lips? This is not doing that. If you saw my lips before I put this on, I need moisturizing for my lips or else they get really dry and crack looking. I'm really liking this. That is the finished look. I'm so happy with it. I'm so happy with how the eyeshadow came out. The mascara, the top and bottom were absolutely amazing. And then of course the lipstick was really, really, really nice. And I'm feeling the color. I actually wasn't sure when I first tried it on if I was gonna like it because it is a little bit more on the cool side. And I usually go for warmer colors, but it's working. It's working with the winter feel of this whole look. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you like seeing some of these products that I had thought were a little bit more winter themed. And I had a lot of fun trying all these. If there's any products you want me to try, leave them down below. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!